Hi, it's just bringing you another update on coronavirus in Bristol and the measures we are taking to keep you safe in the face of this challenge that we have. So a few announcements today. The first around adult social care funding. So we know that you can expect that coronavirus is placing a huge demand on health and social care services. But today we agreed to invest £9.3 million of the money we've received from government to help us meet the increased demand over the next 3 months. Now, this money will specifically pay to help people out of hospital and back into their own homes when they're declared medically fit. And this obviously frees up capacity in our hospitals. Also, it will also bring in additional care staff on a living wage. And £464,000 of this over 3 months will help the voluntary sector to meet the additional demand. We're obviously going to work very closely with health partners in the CCG to allocate the money where it's needed. Situation is changing all the time. We're going to keep in touch with government about what we actually need. Now on charities, really pleased to see the Chancellor take action and now commit money to supporting our voluntary sector. And I've been involved with a number of other city leaders in calling for this. And we know that the voluntary community sector, our charities, are vital to the functioning of our city, not just in the provision of services, but also as key employers in our communities. Now, we think that the announcement is positive, but we do still believe it falls short of the amount that's required. The suggestion is that the sector stands to lose around £4 billion over the coming months as a result of this crisis. So we do need more, and I'll be writing to the Chancellor to ask that he considers, in addition to that, an urgent review of the level of financial support required to stop some of these charities from closing, and also for government to change its furlough rules to allow charity workers who are furloughed to volunteer their services for their organisation, and also an extension of the business loan scheme so it's eligible for all charities. Now on Easter food provision for vulnerable people. So the government has provided food for vulnerable groups who are on the shielding list. We recognise this isn't comprehensive, and we agree today that anyone who has applied to go on this national list but hasn't received a food package can call us for help over the Easter weekend. So you can call the We Are Bristol helpline on 0800 694 0184, 0800 694 0184, and that number is also on the City Council website. So when you, please do not go into crisis alone. Reach out to us, and if you see someone who's in need, reach out to us there. Now, there's an important update on our clean air zone plans in that JACU have written to us and city leaders across the country to advise that the implementation date of the clean air zone plans can be put back in order to protect businesses and jobs. Now, we remain committed to achieving clean air and the improved health associated with that for Bristol in the shortest possible time. That's absolutely essential, and we are confident that the plans we have will enable us to get to compliance by 2023. But we also have to recognise that the economy is not something that sits in an abstract. These are businesses that are going out of business. These are jobs that will be disappearing, and they are critical to social cohesion. They're critical to health outcomes as well. And we have to do that thing of doing the protection of the environment in a just way, not one that further compounds inequalities. So we'll be working with government on this. We'll be asking for increased support for businesses needing to make the transition away from diesel and petrol vehicles as well. And we will commit on our wider climate strategy and ecological strategies to deliver the sustainable city that Bristol must become. Very good piece of news for the city as well, in the name of economic recovery, in that the Secretary of State has advised that they will not be calling in the YTL Arena decision. It should have been a formality, it was, but now we are on track at last to having our 17,000 seater for Bristol, the most sustainable arena in the UK, and probably when it's finished on the planet, because it's being brought through with all these incredible measures from renewables to use of rainwater and so forth. This is hugely significant for the city, bringing jobs and investment. It'd be a sign of confidence and will, as I said, be a key piece of our economic recovery to come in to counter the impact, the negative impact of coronavirus. Now, it's important to say also the Economy Board are leading on the economic recovery strategy and will be really tuned into the need for economic inclusion to make sure that the economic benefits from this arena are shared by the population. And finally, a message for this Easter weekend, please continue to follow the public health guidance, consider your neighbours, consider the staff at the NHS, stay at home, physically distance, minimise that social impact, minimise the chances that someone else will contract the virus and end up in hospital, putting everyone at risk, including themselves.